Good evening, students. Today I'll be talking about fault types and calculation techniques on relay protection design. So if we look at the symmetrical components and fault location technique in the following diagrams. So the first thing what we need to look at is the different fault drawing. So if we consider three-phase fault, we have phase A, phase B, phase C, and fault at each, at the end of the buses. Okay, so that we can draw the positive sequence diagram on here. This the using the voltage Thevenin circuit or Thevenin equivalent circuit. So say for example, we usually put a relay on here to protect the lines connected between bus A and, you know, and the adjacent lines. And if you look on this one, it's two-phase fault. So the phase fault is between phase B and phase C. And then this is the way we can draw the sequence diagrams. So we have a positive sequence, and that is the negative sequence. The only difference is the voltage source. We have only one voltage source because in a double phase fault is the same fault, source voltage. And the third one is the single phase ground fault. Only phase A is faulted, so that we have, because it's to the ground, we have zero sequence, negative sequence and positive sequence, all we need to consider, so that this is the way we draw. Okay, so there's elements are, for example, like E1, E2, E0 are the sequences of the voltage at the terminal, and then the currents are the current sequences, and then E1F, E2F are the voltage at the fault location, and then obviously the Z1F and 2F, 0F are the fault impedances on here. Okay, so now if we consider a diagram, the transmission line at 400 kV transmission network. So we have source injected to the bus A and transmission line between A and B, and of course double circuit between B to C. Obviously we can see the parameter or the sequence impedance is given. Positive impedance, negative sequence, which are the same, and zero sequence. By rule of thumb, zero sequence are three times bigger than the positive or the negative sequence components. Okay, now for a three-phase fault, only positive sequence current exists because we don't have a negative or zero sequences, so that we can calculate what is the phase A current, what is the fault current at the fault point, only phase A or the positive sequence. To do that one, we need to consider the positive impedances, the Z1 basically. So using Ohm's law, current is equal to the voltage divided by the impedance, but the impedance is the total impedance to the fault point, because we have to consider all the fault, the impedances where the fault is flowing through. So phase voltage, that is by root 3, we have to divided by the source impedance plus line impedance between A and B plus total impedances between B and C. Obviously it is double circuit or parallel circuit, so that we have to divide by 2 or just product divide by the R sum. Then the phase current the fault current will be 11.8 kiloamp. Now, how about the voltage at the relay location? We know that the fault current is around 11.8 kiloamp. Now we need the relay must have a voltage information as well, because the relay detect the impedance of the line based on the ratio of current, the voltage divided by the current. Okay, so we know the current, and then now we need the voltage at the relay location. So that to do that, we know the current, and we need to find out what is the impedance before the relay. Okay, now we have to subtract the voltage of the generator minus the source impedance on here times the line current, basically. It has to be like this. Assume this is a... This is A. And then this is the jitter location. Okay. So basically, we need to find out that is the ZS, the source impedance. We need to find out what is the voltage drop between here and here. That is, we multiply by IZ. Okay, the voltage drop. So that's the equivalent to IZ. We know the current, it is this one. And then we know the voltage at this one, the E or the voltage, the electromagnetic volt, that is this one, okay? This minus the voltage drop will be the remaining voltage at bus A on here, 213. So if we divide this, it will give us 230 kilovolt. And then that will be 230 kilovolt phase voltage. And then on here it is 213. So around 17 kilovolt is as a voltage drop on here because of the source impedance, okay? So now we have the voltage. The next step is to calculate the fault impedance. So that what will be the fault impedance seen by the relay? We know we have the voltage. We have the current flowing through the conductor, through the overhead line to the fault point. So that this is the current. So what will be the fault impedance? Obviously it is the ratio of voltage divided by the current. This voltage, however, is at the relay location. Okay, so 230, it could be the ratio of voltage divided by the current is 0.94 plus J18. Basically, this is in a complex number, okay? Then the next step is, well, how do we assess the distance relay zone setting against the fault impedance? This one. So how do we know, like, we calculated the fault impedance on here, but how do we know this which zone of this relay will trip for this fault? Obviously, we know that the measured fault and the line impedance are, this fault impedance is 0.94 plus J18. So if we recalculate into polar form around 18 ohm, the line impedance is this one. 0.63 plus J12, obviously on each of them. Okay, let's take this one. Now it is 12 ohm. And then, so we have to, let's do check in on the zone setting configuration. So zone one is configured 80% of line A, that is around 9.6 ohm. And then zone two is 125% of line AB, so that the total is around 15 ohm. And zone three is 225 or from here, 125 on here, somewhere around here, okay? So that 27 ohm. So now how to know which zone will trip for the fault? Obviously, let's make this clear. The zone one is set 80%. And the zone two is up to 225%, so 125 zone two, okay? So somewhere around there. And then zone three is from here up to, so that is 100% of the line plus 100% of this one plus 25. So somewhere say just 25 past this one is somewhere around here, okay? Up to here. So zone three, zone two, and zone one. Okay, now which zone will trip? Let's do a quick check. So look at the fault impedance. If the fault impedance is less than the line impedance, well, we have the fault impedance, this one, 18 ohm, So we compare this one against this one. So is this 18 impedance is not less than this one, so this relay will not trip. And if we look at 18 ohm against this one, this is not also less than this one, so this relay will not trip again. And then if we compare 18 ohm, faulty impedance is less than 27 ohm, which is correct, which satisfies this one, so this relay will trip. So this relay will trip in zone 3 time.